Little, very little, will induce me to cover your faults with a veil of charity. I already feel a kind of participation in all that concerns you. All praises and censures bestowed on you must equally affect me. Your joys and sorrows must be mine. Thus shall the one be increased and the other diminished. While this is the case, we shall, I hope, always find life's cares to be comforts. And may we feel every trial and distress, for such must be our lot at times, bind us nearer to God and to each other. My heart earnestly joins in your comprehensive prayers. I trust they will unitedly ascend to a throne of grace, and through the Redeemer's merits, procure for us peace and happiness here, and a life of eternal felicity hereafter. Oh, what sacred pleasure there is in the idea of spending an eternity together in perfect and uninterrupted bliss. This should encourage us to the utmost exertion and fortitude. But whilst I write, my own words condemn me. I am ashamed of my own indolence and backwardness to duty. May I be more careful, watchful, and active than I have ever yet been. My uncle, aunt, and Jane request me to send their kind regards, and they will be happy to see you any time next week, whenever you can conveniently come down from Bradford. Let me hear from you soon. I shall expect a letter on Monday. Farewell, my dearest friend. That you may be happy in yourself and very useful to all around you is the daily earnest prayer of yours truly, Maria Branwell.